All right, so don't mind my very messy workspace here. I just cut my circle, okay? So I try to get mine as big as I can, but I lose some space where the wheels are on my machine, and so it always pushes it over a little bit. So I did have to cut a little bit of this line right here. But I created a 24-inch circle, and then I made my design 23. And that allows me to pull this section out and get that design. So then I just weed all of my design and put my transfer tape on. And then I use this to line up on my cable spool. Always weed my center just because it helps me center my design. Bear with me a moment here. Is pretty forgiving if I accidentally put it down and get it in the wrong spot. Oop. I can usually pull it back up, but it's not too big of a deal. Slightly. Close, but it doesn't have to be exact. It's a little bit trickier when you have to piece two pieces together. But just line everything up and cable spool, and I just used a dry brush and threw a little black paint on there. Nothing fancy at all. I do find the top of my board. I'll put like a little something over here so I can kind of mark my spot. And then I find my 12. This is my 12, so the center of this little thing is what I use to line up at the top. But then I go around and I kind of figure out where these holes are. And if I need to change the direction of my cable spool, like sometimes I'll have like a hole like here or here, but if I can kind of put it in the center, or you know, so I don't cut off as much lettering as possible, sometimes I'll move that kind of depending, but. Pretty much I just line it up where it needs to be. And put it on. Well, you know what? I didn't sand this. Oh, I better sand that. Always, always, always sand. before you put a stencil on, to smooth out your board. It'll help with paint bleeds. Try to do the jiggle. Wipe it down a little bit. Careful you don't get any splinters. We're gonna try this again. Now I'm kind of a freak about things being perfectly like straight. I don't know, it's pretty weird, but like I said, I'm just gonna line that up there. Now I have a little bit of overlap on all sides of my stencil, so I'm just kind of making sure that that's about the same all the way around, so that that design isn't like off, you know, really far over on one side and not the other. But I think this is, pretty good. All right. Get that down. What did I do with my little spatula? Oh, here it is. Flip this over and peel up. Just don't crease your stencil. Okay, I'm gonna take the back side because it's firmer, and just rub. Take this transfer tape off. You just want to make sure that your stencil is kind of staying down. You might have to use your finger and kind of regular stain, your stencil won't stick well to stain. So just, you're gonna have a harder time getting your stencil on. And I just use my finger and kind of smooth that down. We'll go back over it in a minute. Bubble right here. Watch out for that. Just get it to stick as good as you can. I think it's warm in here. And then I'm going to take this, I'm going to put the shiny side down, and I'm just going to rub to help get that stuck down good. Where it lifted. All I kind of take my finger and press down in between any little spots. And I'm gonna take a little piece of tape. I'm just gonna tape off this edge over here because I will be messy and accidentally get paint on my spool over here, and we don't wanna do that. So I'm just gonna, if it'll even stick, I don't even know if it'll stay. All right, now, I try to reuse my stencil backing, that paper, for my paint. And you can use a paper plate or whatever you got. So I'm just gonna stick a little white paint on there. And you can use either a stencil brush, something with some pretty firm, or a sponge. Less is best. So I'm gonna go with the sponge because that's been working well for me lately. And we're just lightly I do like a little dab with a little drag. If there's a hole, you don't want to be pushing paint down in there. Be very careful. Now you can't really tell, but I'm like barely pressing down on the sponge because I don't want to push paint down underneath my stencil, especially like in the places where it's not attached real well. If you feel like you're smushing, you need more paint. You're gonna do two coats on the whole thing. If you use too much paint, you're gonna have a lot of paint bleeds. Especially like in any of these little cracks. And there's cracks and holes all over on these things. So if there's a spot at the end where I feel like it needs a little bit of paint, it's much easier to add a little spot of paint somewhere than it is to dig it back out of all the places that it bled and you used too much paint. Okay, coat one. Let me get a little more paint over here. We're gonna do one more coat. You got to remember that these are supposed to be rustic, so they don't need to have every square inch of the stencil covered with paint. They're not supposed to be. They're supposed to be look worn out and beat up and all the things. And we are almost there. Okay. I might go back and hit a few spots. Losing my spot here. All right, we're gonna go with that. Pull this off. Pull this one off. Going to pull this one off. That's not too bad. I really don't have much for touch-ups. I did get some paint bleed here, so I'm gonna use my weeding tool, and I'm just gonna kind of scrape the edges and clean those up a little bit. It's my favorite trick. Much easier than trying to go in with the black paint and try to smooth them that way. So there's that. I got a little bit of white paint here. But overall, that is absolutely fabulous. Ta-ta-da! Don't you think? All right, if you have any questions, you let me know.